tomorrow tonight, folks, 60 minutes of fun and music brought to you by Panna Toothpaste and Sal Hepatica. Fun with our star comedian Fred Allen and his Mighty Allen Art Players. Music with Peter Van Steeden and the Ipana Troubadours, the Town Hall Quartet, and to round out a great show, Fred Allen presents a new group of amateurs eager for their first appearance on the big time. It's Town Hall tonight. Well, the band's playing, the crowd's cheering, and here comes Fred Allen leading a new big colorful parade to the old town hall. So come on, folks, let's march along with them. Everybody's going. Here they come, lovebirds.
You've been seeing my daughter every Wednesday, John. What are your intentions?
It ain't love. I'm just coming to hear the radio, Mrs. Bloom. It's town hall tonight.
Neighbors.
You better turn off that radio, lady. It's anti-noise week.
I won't turn it off if you call out the militia, officer. It's town hall tonight.
Spiritualist.
There's a spirit in your radio, Yogi. It's jumping up and down.
My radio is only jumping for joy, sister. It's town hall tonight.
Well, there's Fred now talking to the crowd outside the door of the town hall. He's certainly in fine fettle tonight. Let's listen to what he says.
Lulu's back in town, ladies and gentlemen, and she's on the inside. Everyone's on the inside this evening because it's town hall tonight. Line forms to the right, please.
Lulu, evening, Brother Allen.
And a happy dusk to you, Mrs. Green. How are all the little greens these days?
Oh, they're all old enough to be right, Mr. Allen.
Some talking back, Mrs. Green. Go right in. I've got a big show tonight, folks, so hurry, 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 hurry.
Hi there, Wendy.
Hello, Luke. How are things down at the brewery?
Happy days are here again, Brother Allen. Wow!
Tonight's the night. Hey, Luke, test your abilities on the inside, folks. A laugh a day will air condition the gums. Hurry, 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 hurry.
We're all set, Fred. Are you ready to start?
Yes, Tiny. The opening number is Broadway Rhythm.
Okay, Peter, let's go.
Gotta dance, gotta dance. Broadway Rhythm, it's got me.
Everybody dance.
Broadway Rhythm, it's got me.
Everybody dance.
Out on the gay white way, beneath merry cafe, orchestra play, taking your breath away with a Broadway Rhythm, it's got me.
Everybody sing
and dance.
Presenting that dashing distributor of jewelry and drama, the dynamic Fred Allen in person.
Thank you. Thank you, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Now, before rattling the skeleton in our closet of fun, I'll read you the town hall bulletin for tonight. Hodge White is resigning as fish and game warden. Hodge says he didn't mind people calling him game head, but when little kids on the street started calling him fish head, it's time to quit. There will be an election to fill the office as soon as Hodge remembers where he put the badge. So much for matters of civic import, and now for the town hall news. Is the P.S. ready, Tiny?
The picture sheet? Coming right down, Fred.
Will you? Will you save the kilowatts, please?
Turn off the light. It's a pleasure.
The projector starts, and we bring you the latest news of the week. The Town Hall News sees nothing, shows all. Albany, New York.
Governor Lehman, after 4-day conference on crime problem, recommends that all revolver owners receive shooting instruction. Town Hall News shows how police employees will instruct housewives in use of firearms.
Open up!
942 Park Avenue.
I'm from headquarters, Bud. It's about Mrs. Vanderbilt's revolver lesson.
Enter, please.
What is it, Trevors?
A gentleman about your revolver lesson, Mrs. Vanderbilt.
Thank you, Trevors. Show him in.
I'm Red Pearson, Mrs. V. The captain sent me over to give you a lowdown on your gap.
My gap?
Your rod. You know, your Roscoe.
Really, officer, your precinct patois is confusing.
Oh, your gun. You gotta get instructions.
Oh, yes, my fouling tee.
Yeah. You got your gun handy?
It's right here on the high boy. Here it is.
Oh, you're a 36, eh? You got a smooth barrel, too.
I was a 36, but my barrel is about a 40. I didn't think you'd notice it. I must diet.
My mistake.
Oh, no, my mistake. Too many starches.
I'm speaking about your gun. Are you ready?
Righto. Now, do I point with this round part hanging down?
Oh, no. Your finger goes through there.
In here?
No, that's the nozzle. This here's the trigger.
Oh, yes. I pull this.
No, not yet. I'll tell you when.
Oh, I'll pull it easy. I just want to see the bullet come out a little way.
Steady, Mrs. Vanderbilt. Now, here's the first lesson. Suppose a burglar is coming in that door.
Yes.
Let me see you get him.
Righto.
That's fine.
Oh, it's too simple, isn't it?
Yeah, if he was coming down the chandelier, you'd have had him.
Trenton, New Jersey. Banking Commission sets interest rate for savings banks at 2%. If interest rates shrink further, banks may refuse to accept deposits. Town Hall News shows what may happen in banks of tomorrow. Scene, the interior of the last national bank.
Yes, sir?
Where's the receiving teller, miss?
Second window to the left.
Thank you.
Well, sir, what can I do for you?
I want to make a deposit.
Don't you see that sign? Bums, tramps, and depositors keep out.
Yeah, but I got a letter from my congressman.
Congratulations. Mine can't write.
I'm Mendel Trimble, the gum slot king. I got $800 in pennies in this bag.
I'm sorry, Mr. Trimble, but the last national bank has shut down on deposits. Now, if you wanted to borrow a million or two...
Oh, no. Now, see here.
Then you're wasting my time, Trimble. Now, pick up your pennies and scram.
Well, that's the way you feel about it. Stick them up.
Here, put down that gun.
I hate to lose my temper, but you're going to take this deposit or I'll blow you.
Don't shoot. I'll take it.
Here. Now, keep quiet while I make my getaway.
Help! Police! A deposit! Help! A deposit!
East Cleveland, Ohio. Local housewives petition city council to pass ordinance prohibiting doorbell ringing. If law is passed, peddlers and salesmen will have to use other means to get women to their doors. Town Hall News shows what may happen. Seen any house in East Cleveland.
Goodbye, Gwendolyn, darling. Now hurry up. You'll be late for school.
Oh, look, Ma. Somebody left an icebox on the piazza.
What?
An icebox.
Well, land's sakes, I ain't ordered no icebox.
Maybe there's a note inside.
Well, stand back here. Mama'll open it.
Oh, look, there's a man in there, Mommy.
Good morning, madam. I'm working my way through college. How about a year subscription, a chambermaid's confession?
Vendors and hawkers may appear with musical instruments. A typical backyard.
Will you get away from here with that bugle?
Fifth, nice, fresh, fifth.
Enterprising salesmen may band together and form glee clubs. Housewives may soon be hearing this.
Well?
Good morning, madam. Hear the brush that'll pick up all your crumbs. A dollar down and a dollar a week.
I don't need none. You bum.
Once again, the Town Hall News brings you the outstanding sound of the week. Geneva, Switzerland. League of Nations finds Italy guilty. Mussolini continues attack. Ethiopia prepares to draft more troops. The draft.
Well, say, Fred, I have a picture here that I'd like to throw on the screen. A picture that's been seen by a lot of people these past 2 weeks.
All right, Connie, let's have it.
Okay, lights out. Now, friends, there on the screen you see a young lady just as she appears to millions of readers of the Saturday Evening Post, Collier's, Liberty, and Life. She's wide-eyed and her nose turns up, and she's every day at 10 and a half. And here's the young lady in person. She has something to say to us.
Never as long as I live am I going to have pink toothbrush.
And do you know what pink toothbrush is?
Yes, sir. Pink toothbrush is what would happen if my gums got sore and tender. And I'm never going to have that, because I use Ipana toothpaste with massage.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this modern young lady uses Ipana toothpaste to brush her teeth and to massage her gums. Her mother, her teacher have told her that merely brushing the teeth is not enough. So each morning, each evening, after she brushes her teeth with Ipana, she also gently massages her gums with this famous toothpaste. She knows that Ipana is designed specifically to help keep her gums firm and strong, as well as to make her teeth bright and shining. And the important thing, friends, is this. If you will do what she does, use Ipana toothpaste with massage, you too can have brighter teeth, firmer, healthier gums.
Troubadours have just played I've Got a Feeling You're Foolin'. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I have been asked to make a banal announcement. Pop Mullen, man about hors d'oeuvre at that popular lunch wagon, Belle of the Gutter, says that Fire Prevention Week starts on Monday. Now, Pop's observing the week 100%. The wagon's serving nothing but cold cuts, and Pop's... That's the worst. I'm on a vegetarian diet. You see, even the mention of meat upsets me vocally. Pop's observing Fire Prevention Week 100%. The wagon's serving nothing but cold cuts. And Pop's sending word to an old flame of his not to show up around the wagon all week. Now on Thursday...
Mr. Allen!
Now here. If that's somebody testing an echo, you'll hear from me before the echo can even get a word in edgewise.
Hello.
Well, sir, as I live and try to keep the hands of my wristwatch from reaching up and feeling my pulse, if it isn't Portland.
Yes, I've been enjoying myself all day, so I thought I'd stop in and get upset. For a change.
Are you inferring that my presence on the rostrum here tends to induce ennui?
Papa says your acting will cure insomnia quicker than a bromide.
My compliments to your father, and tell him I'd like to borrow his head for some crystal gazing over the weekend.
Gosh, I guess I made a mistake bringing up Papa.
No, that was your grandfather's mistake.
Well, I like that.
Your family crest should be a faux pas rampant on a field of simpletons.
don't change the subject. What's a faux pas?
Faux pas, or faux pas, is a French expression. Faux, meaning four in the southern part of France. Faux. Par is father in any language. Faux pas, meaning forefather.
Do you speak French?
Well, I picked up a little when the Normandy docked the last time. But you and Papa wouldn't understand it.
Oh, you can laugh, but Papa'll make a fortune one of these days.
Well, he may make money, but he'll never be able to pass it.
Well, Smarty, he's out buying a store right now. It's a pet shop.
Say, he's been leading a dog's life so long, he ought to feel at home in a pet shop. How did he come to buy the place?
Well, the man who owned it wasn't feeling well. He wanted to sell out.
What made him sick? Looking at the cash register?
No, it's the government's fault.
Oh, how could the great big government upset a little teeny-weeny, itsy-bitsy pet shop? Leave a used blue eagle in there?
No, the president said that business should take a breathing spell.
That's right, a breathing spell is stimulating.
Did you ever take a deep breath in a pet shop?
Oh. I get it. Well, I guess you're aching to see if our exits are in good order.
Oh, I knew that was coming. Well, Andy. Oh,
no, anybody but... Oh, no.
Wahoo, 40. I thought you'd never get to call me. I've been setting on pins and needles.
Well, you didn't have to get up on my account.
Now, don't let's have any rumpus, Mr. Allen.
Now, don't you worry, Potty. I'm ready for Mr. Quirk tonight. He'd better not come the razzle-dazzle on to me.
If you want to stay at large, you better pull that hat down over your head until potato control blows over.
Gosh, you two get along like salapatica and water.
Oh, gherkins. You can't put on the fancy Nancy with me, old curd taste. If you think I was born yesterday, you can look into the birth notices and see difference.
If you'll just stop parting your face in the middle, we'll get along a whole lot better.
Oh, don't mind Mr. Allen, Willoughby.
Lord, I'm about as welcome as a knothole at a wooden wedding.
Yes, you don't have to wax personal, Mr. Allen. Willoughby's a brother out, aren't you, Willoughby?
No, I ain't, Potty. This ain't no tooth. It's a piece of macaroni on some of it.
Yes, and you ought to get a new set of buttonholes put in for those lima beans there, too.
Yes, Willoughby, your best does look appetizing.
Appetizing? It looks as though a cafeteria dinner exploded on his tray.
Says you. Now, see here. Let's get down to brass tacks.
I'll say we're here on business. Tell him, Willoughby.
It's anti-noise week, but you're tooting, Potty. I come down to see about hiring the town hall.
I told you, Mr. Allen, Willoughby's got something on his mind.
If he has, it's seeped in through his scalp. What is it, Willoughby?
Well, sir, I've been thinking of renting a hall here for a wedding.
Who's going to be married, Willoughby?
Well, I didn't come to brag.
Oh, Willoughby! Look, he's blushing, Mr. Allen.
No, I ain't either blushing. It's this darn union suit. Every time I perspire, she tightens up onto me.
Willoughby's getting married! Willoughby's getting married!
Fudge, now you hush up, Potty. I ain't hitched yet.
How come the wedding so sudden, Willoughby? Did she say yes?
Oh, the girl ain't said nothing up now. It's her pa.
I get it. The woodpile has a tenant. I can see that.
What happened, Willoughby?
Well, sir, last Wednesday night, I was down at this certain party's house. We was dancing to the radio.
Doing a hoedown, eh?
No, I was doing the cheek-to-cheek.
Oh, boy, and did you pivot?
No, I didn't get a chance. We was tripping it hot and heavy, though. And then she says, swing it, Willoughby. With that, her pa came into the door.
Trying to cut in, hey?
No, he didn't pull no knife. Trouble was, he didn't hear the music. I say, he ups to me and he says, young man, I'll expect you to do the right thing by my daughter.
Well, it looks as though you're hooked, Willoughby, and they saved the bait.
Yes, you've got to pay the fiddler.
Hey, that's why I'm setting my plans. What's the cost for the hall?
To you, $25 in advance.
Oh, rubbing it in, eh? I always knew you was a profiteer. Well, I ain't aiming to pay it.
It's okay with me.
$25. If it comes to a showdown, the wedding's off. She can sue me for breach of karaoke. And good riddance, too.
Oh, don't go away mad, Willoughby.
No, just go away, Willoughby.
I'd better stop him. He may do something desperate.
Now, don't you interfere unless he's doing something trivial. Goodbye, Portland.
Tally-ho!
And now, auditioning for Willoughby's wedding, the Town Hall Quartet sings Since Yussel Learned to Yodel.
One day Yussel took a vocal lesson. He sang so good, he sang so well, he sold his delicatessen. Next day, oy vey, he bought a swell guitar, and overnight became a star. Since Yussel learned to yodel, he's a Yiddish mountaineer.
Now everybody hears him on the radio far and near.
Listen, there he is now.
I give me your home where the buffaloes run, with the deer of the antelopes playing.
And every time he speaks to you, he's always
a high-yowling.
It's strange how lately he took on a certain southern drawling. Since Yussel learned to yodel, he keeps thinking of his career.
So he's learned to ride a horse here, just like a Yiddish quarry weir.
The mountain's going places.
Why not? It's on a business basis.
Since Yussel learned to yodel, he's a Yiddish mountaineer. He'll be coming round the Catskills when he's coming. Boy, he'll be coming round the Catskills.
Since Yussel learned to yodel, he's a Yiddish mountaineer.
He used to rope salami, now he's roping a Texas steer. He sings them cowboy songs, of course, but pardon my declaring.
The other cowboys smell from horses.
The same time Yussel smells from herring.
Since Yussel learned to yodel, now he's wearing a cowboy hat.
And boots with furs and chaps with furs, he's changing his name to Pat. He takes some awful chances, he's playing German dances. Since Yussel learned to yodel.
Oi, 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 Mazel Tov. Well, yodel,
So what did I think about Yussel?
He's a Yiddish mountaineer.
Now before Fred brings out his mighty Allen Art players, I have a brief drama in two acts that I want to present. The cast of two people is all ready. Curtain.
Why, Daddy, home from work so early?
Yes, sweetheart. Your daddy's kind of got the glums. I feel half sick. I should have done something about it sooner. Tell Mother I'm going to take some salipatic and lie down a half hour or so.
Curtain! And now between the acts, friends, just a word. The man in this playlet drinks 2 teaspoonfuls of salipatic in a glass of water about a half hour or so before dinner. And friends, that is wise when you really need immediate relief from those 2 troubles, poisonous waste in your body and an acid condition throughout your system. Salipatica is the laxative, as you know, that both rids you of those wastes and combats your excess acidity, building up your alkaline reserve so necessary to good health. Now let's get back to our little playlet. The time, later that evening. Same little girl, same man. Curtain?
Well, Daddy, what are you going to do? Turn on the radio?
You bet I am. I feel like some music.
Oh, Freddy, you're feeling all right now, aren't you, Daddy?
Feeling swell, sweetheart. Never felt better in my life.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the mighty Allen Art Players. Every one of these old troopers has earned his B.A. degree, Butcher of Art. Tonight, they present a murder mystery melodrama entitled Murder in the Dark, or Who Killed Kirk Rubin? Over to you, Peter.
Yeah, that must be Alec.
Come in.
Dinner is saved, madam.
Thank you, Alec. Are you ready, Sylvia?
Yes, Mrs. Rubin.
Come on, Kirk. Darling.
Just a moment, dear, till I turn out the light. Here they go. Can you see in the dark, Mr. Rubin?
Calling all cars. Calling all cars. Kirk Rubin murdered. Detective One Long Pan. Proceed at once to number 13 River Road. Be careful, One Long Pan. Calling all pans. Calling all cans.
Come in.
Salutations, Madam Rubin. Greetings. Hi-ho, everybody. My time is your time.
Oh, they've killed my poor husband.
One long pan is prepared to solve mystery. Toot sweet, toot. Madam? Madam, I am the great pan.
Say, I could use you under my icebox.
No, no. Business before pleasure, madam. First, I will find out who killed Kirk Rubin. Where was despicable crime committed?
It all happened in the living room, right through here.
Oh, excuse us.
Why, Alex, Sylvia, what are you two doing in here?
Quiet.
Who are these suspicious characters?
This is Sylvia, my husband's private secretary, and this is Alex, the family butler. They were in this room with me when my husband was killed.
Quiet. Clean up your laughs. I can't. First, one along pan, get oil assistance. More support. Whistle for policeman.
Okay, Pan, you're slow enough. Ain't you solved this one yet?
When the long Pan finds answer one question, mystery is solved.
What's the question?
Who killed Kirk Rubin?
I set the sparrow with my little arrow.
Oh, wise guy, Shay. You give one long Pan the sparrow.
Hey, listen, long puss. I'm Alec, the butler. Butler, I don't know nothing. Now, the police doctor says Kirk Rubin was killed by some poison which was squirted into his bloodstream someplace. But they couldn't find no weapon and no wounds, see?
Oh, so you won't keep quiet, huh? Well, things look pretty black for you.
Everything looked black when criminal wind up behind eight ball.
I demand that my husband's murderer be found at once.
Everything clear as crystal, Madam Rubin. But first, Wong Tan conduct little experiment. Purely psychological.
What are you going to do?
We will reenact crime.
Well, if you're going to reenact the crime, I was standing here.
I'll go out and make me entrance.
Well, I was here.
And my husband was right there where he switched off the light.
I'll play the part of Kirk Rubin. It's the lead.
Very good, Sergeant. Places, everybody. You'll show one long pun exactly what happened when Kirk Rubin killed. Ready? Go!
Mrs. Rubin!
Come in, Alex.
Dinner is saved, madam.
Good. Come, Sylvia. You too, Kirk, darling.
I'm starved.
Just a moment. I'll turn out the lights. Here they go.
Can you see in the dark, Mr. Rubin?
Oh!
What happened? Turn out the lights! Turn out the lights!
Heavens, look!
The sergeant!
Sergeant! Speak, sergeant. Who killed you?
Alec.
He's dead.
Exactly. Grim Reaper plow under. Long Pan beginning to suspect foul play here.
But you all heard him. He accused Alec.
You keep your midi on, Mrs. Rubin. Everything here clear as crystal. One the Long Pan, three enact crime again. Check up.
Again?
Precisely.
Hey, you better get another copper.
I blow whistle.
On the job, Pan. What's on your celestial mind?
We reenact crime once more. You be Kirk Rubin.
I gotcha.
Hey, careful there, copper. Don't step on the sergeant.
Outside, you. Make him very fast this time.
Okay, but I ain't responsible.
Very fast now. Snap it. One, two, three.
Mrs. Rubin.
Come in, Alex.
In recite, madam.
Good. Come, Sylvia. You too, Kirk, darling.
I'm starved.
Just a moment. I'll turn out the lights. Here they go.
Can you see in the dark, Mr. Rubin?
Turn on the lights!
Well, one long pan?
Don't look now, but I think there's another dead policeman on the lawn.
Oh,
he's still alive. Who did it?
Alec.
Oh, he's dead.
Now listen to me, one long pan. You can't come in here and clutter up my floor like this.
Long pan, take full responsibility. If body's not called for 30 days, you are lucky winner.
That policeman accused Alec.
I'm innocent as a newborn lamb, I tell you.
Quiet. Everything here clear as crystal. One long pan got new theory. We reenact crime.
Again?
Yes, precisely. But one the long pan got no more policeman. I will take Alec's place. Alec, you will play Kirk Rubin's part.
Nothing doing. I don't want to get minded.
Miss Sylvia, you oblige. You will play Kirk Rubin's part.
I should say not. Well, I'm not afraid. I'll play my husband's part.
Very good. I will play your part, Mrs. Rubin. Female impersonator. Whoops. Outside, Alec.
Okay.
Mrs. Rubin!
Come here, Alec.
Dinner is safe, madam.
Good.
Come, Sylvia. You too, Kirk, darling.
I'm starved. Just a moment. I'll turn out the lights. Here they...
Stop! No move. Everybody hold everything.
Well, what's the matter? What was the trouble?
Long pants off, mister. Everything here is crystal.
What do you mean?
I'm innocent as a lamb. Mr. Shilton, you have something on finger. You show long pants. Come clean to it.
Why, it's nothing. It's just an old symbol I've been sewing.
You're no fool, long pun. You're going to turn out right with symbol instead of finger.
Why, this is ridiculous.
No, not ridiculous. Not ridiculous. You killed Kirk Rubin.
What? It was Alec. You heard those men say Alec?
Exactly. They all say Alec. They try to say electric light button.
Electric light button?
Precisely. I show you. This button here, turn right out. Careful, don't touch.
Look, there's a needle under that button.
Precisely. A poison needle. Sulfuric acid. H2SO4. Now change battlefield 9. Your husband and 2 policemen assorted.
All right, I confess. Take me away.
Say,
she'll get the hot seat for this.
People who fool around with needle always get it in the end.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, while the stage is being made ready for our amateurs, I'm going to turn back the clock to last Saturday evening. Yes, friends, let's go back to Saturday and listen to what the radio announcers were broadcasting. Are you ready? Here we go.
Notre Dame, 14. Carnegie, 3. Pennsylvania, 6. Princeton, 7. Alabama, 39. George Washington, nothing. Stanford, 10. San Francisco, nothing.
That's what we heard on Saturday.
Now, wait a minute, Tiny. I thought you were going to say something about Ipana toothpaste.
I am, Fred. There's a connection between the scores of those football games and Ipana.
Yeah?
And here, folks, is what I mean. Every football coach realizes that his team must be in tip-top physical shape before it goes into the battle. And you know, and I know, how important physical condition is to our own success. Yet, in one respect, many of us are guilty of neglect. We fail to care for those guardians of the health of our teeth, the gums. Dental authorities will tell you...
The gums need exercise, just as the body needs exercise.
And what's the best way to give the gums the exercise they need? Why, to massage them with Ipana toothpaste. Ipana is the toothpaste made specifically to help tone, stimulate, strengthen the gums when used with massage. Used to brush your teeth, Ipana will make them cleaner and more brilliant. Used to massage your gums, Ipana will help keep them firm and strong. To have teeth and gums healthy as a star football player, use Ipana toothpaste with massage. Well, isn't this a lovely day from Top Hat, played by the Ipana Troubadours and sung by the Town Hall Quartet. And now here comes Fred Allen out on the stage to present his weekly amateur contest.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, here they are, another group of eager neophytes ready to entertain you with instrument and song. Before we start, though, I want to name the winner of last week's contest, chosen, you remember, by the vote of our radio listeners. The first prize is $100, and the winning act, ladies and gentlemen, is the Friendly Four, the four gentlemen from Pine Grove, Pennsylvania, who sang the medley of old-time songs. Congratulations, Friendly Four, and many thanks for your visit. Now, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have two prizes. The first is $50 in cash and a week's engagement at the Roxy Theater in New York City. And the second prize is $25 in cash. Once again, you folks here in Town Hall will determine the winners. Your applause will be recorded on the Johns Manville applause meter here on the stage. The three acts receiving the most applause will be called back later for your final selection for the first two prizes. Now, first this evening, we welcome the Sickles Hayseeders, a hillbilly band from Saugerties, New York. Is that pronunciation
that's
right?
That's right, Mr. Allen.
Saugerties?
That's correct.
How far is Saugerties from New York as the crow flies?
As the crow flies, about 109 miles.
Is it? Does the crow stop there, incidentally?
Well, once in a while.
See, how many folks are in the band?
We have 12.
12 in the band? Yes. All from Saugerties?
All from Saugerties.
You're not Mr. Sickles, are you?
I'm Mr. Gardner.
Mr. Gardner?
That's right.
Glad to know you. I'm Major Allen, Mr. Gardner. I'm very glad to know you.
I know you, Major.
But I was wondering, say, if you were 11 or 12, did you say?
Oh.
With you 12 down here tonight, it must look pretty empty up there in Saugerties. But who founded the band?
Mr. Sickles.
Mr. Sickles?
Yes.
Is he a musician?
Well, sort of a musician. He used to be an old band player.
An old band player?
Quite a lot.
He founded this band just for a hobby?
Just for a hobby.
Someone told me that he was the postmaster up there. Is that right?
He is the postmaster, but he's in the post office.
I thought perhaps he started the band to keep you fellas from hanging around the post office.
Well, he did that, yeah.
Yes. Or either that, or if you studied through the mail that he practiced on the instruments before he turned them loose to the board. What are you going to play for it?
We're
going to
play Hand Me Down My Walking Cane.
Hand Me Down. You'll have to split it up for 12 of you. You'll only get practically a splinter apiece tonight, won't you? Well, go right ahead. Thank you. Connie, will you ask the boy with the washboard to leave that around? I want to do up a shirt later before I...
I'm on the way, Fred.
Thank you very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the immediate vicinity of our microphone is considerably brightened through the presence of Miss Betty Riley of Brooklyn. Is that right, Betty?
That's right, Miss Allen.
It's really a pity television hasn't come in so that our listeners who are home might see how attractive you really are.
Oh, I think you say that to all the girls, Mr. Allen.
No, I meet very few girls in my official capacity here at the microphone, you see. But that was very good. You sort of surprised me, Betty. But television has me worried. I imagine it'll be the end of me, television. Imagine at 9 o'clock around the country and someone says on the air, Town Hall tonight, and my face pops out of the microphone, and 8 million kiddies around the country start running for closets. And you're going to sing for us, Betty. You live in Brooklyn, don't you?
Yes, ma'am.
You employed in Brooklyn or New York?
In New York.
In New York, are you? Do you mind if I ask you in what capacity you are employed?
Well, I'm doing a little modeling for one of the Fifth Avenue shops.
Oh, are you?
Uh-huh.
Well, I just wanted to make sure, because I thought perhaps if you had come from Macy's, you might sing lower, and then we'd have to sing. And what are you going to... What are you going to sing for us, Betty?
I'm going to sing that Morton Downey tune of a few seasons ago.
What?
I'll always be in love with you.
Oh, Miss Really, Miss Riley. Riley, Miss Really. I'll always be in love.
Uh-huh.
Well, thank you. It's quite complimentary. You go right ahead. Gentlemen, there's a gentleman approaching the microphone wearing a sports shirt. It's strictly informal here. I mean, even the suspenders, if you didn't. People Jack Kay of Mamaroneck, New York. Is that right, Mr. Kay?
That's right.
I have Steeplejack as your first name. That isn't your first name, is
well,
it?
Well, being I climbed all the flagpoles and steeples all over the United States, not all of them, but pretty near all of them, being the first man to paint the pole of the Flatiron Building in 1903, you can call me a Steeplejack.
Well, I... Well, just don't pin me down to calling you that on such short acquaintance, I mean. But, I imagine coming from Mamaroneck, there isn't much steeplejack work around Mamaroneck, is there?
Well, not that you can notice.
I imagine being a steeplejack in Mamaroneck is something like being a blacksmith in a one-horse town. I mean, where I live, everything is so flat, the man who polishes the top of a hydrant is called a steeplejack where we come from. And you, it's very interesting steeplejack work, though. I've heard quite a lot about it, but I've never met one before. I often wondered why, when they put those weather vanes up, why they always put a rooster as a symbol for the weather vane. Do you know? Is there any particular story that goes with that?
Well, there is, but I won't tell you what it is.
Oh, I say. Sort of a professional secret, I guess. Well, I heard that it was because if they put a hen up on top of those buildings and it laid an egg, it'd be a lot of trouble to go up and get it. So for that, please. But you're a trick harmonica player, Mr. Kay.
I play three harmonicas at once, and I play a harmonica in the back of my neck.
You play a harmonica at the back of your neck?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. There's no risk of dislocation setting in. I mean, if we don't...
Well, I'm very careful all around, and I'll be careful on that, Mike.
All right. Now, what are you going to play for us first?
Well, I'll give you a quick tune, and I'll also play an Art of the Capri, and then I'll give you a few imitations.
All right.
All right?
All right.
Here's why I'm sweating back of my neck.
All right, I'll explain it. Mr. K, the ranges are short about 2 feet of... Wait a minute, Mr. K, just let me... I'll explain it so the people will know what's going on. We can't have such a conglomeration of entertainment going on at once. I'll explain what it is. Mr. K has a short rubber hose here, which he inserts in his mouth and stretches it around to the back of his neck, where, without the aid of a mirror, he locates a harmonica, apparently, and plays it. Go right ahead, Mr. K. Thank you very much, okay. Now, what is your first imitation?
I'm trying a car, stopping in a railroad depot, going outside of the depot and over the railroad bridge and in the distance.
Any particular road or just...
Well, I would say...
Pennsylvania. All right.
All aboard!
Sorry, but we didn't have time to hear your other imitations. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Alfred James from New York City. Mr. James, according to my little slip here, you are a lawyer.
No.
Aren't you?
No.
Well, I'm generally wrong. Now I'm 100%. I mean, I thought for once I would be right.
No, I'd give you about 80%.
80%?
Yes, I'm a law clerk.
Oh, a law clerk. Well, I mean, if you keep trying, you'll be a lawyer in time. I
won't make much difference.
What are you going to sing for it?
I'd like to sing...
I don't want to rush you, but we're a little late. Mr.
You and the night and the music.
You and the night and the music? Well, just the night and the music. Leave me out of it, if you will. Thank you.
You and the night and the music fill me with flaming desire, setting my being completely on fire. You and the night and the music thrill me, but will we be one? After the night and the music are dark, until the pale light of daylight and dawning, our hearts shall be throbbing guitars. Morning may come without warning, and steal away the stars. If we must live for the moment, love till the moment is through. After the night and the music die, will I hide?
Thank you. That was Alfred James, ladies and gentlemen. I've forgotten to tell you folks that Thursday, Friday, and Saturday of this week, the Town Hall Amateur Unit is playing the Strand Theater in York, Pennsylvania. I can assure you, York, that there is a treat in store for you Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Bob King, an accordionist. Word always trips me up, Bob. You were judging from the number of accordion players we've seen lately. The accordion is certainly coming back into popularity, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
How many notes are there on the accordion?
Oh, 120 basses and 41 treble keys.
About 160 notes, the same as my car. Well, you probably get a lot more out of it than I get out. What are you going to play for us, Bob?
12th Street Rag.
12th Street Rag. Thank you. Is that right, Miss Roberts? Would you rather stand over here? We only have a short time, and I'm not going to take up your time. I'm just going to ask you what you'd like to sing.
Smoke Gets in Your Eyes.
Oh, a sequel to Hot Lips, huh? Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. You go right ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.
That completes our list of amateurs for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Now, Tiny, will you take the helm while I go below to see about the results?
Certainly, Fred. Friends, in the few seconds while we're waiting for the results, I'd like to ask you a question. Have you a bottle of Sal Hepatica handy at home? When some member of the family needs a laxative, is Sal Hepatica there ready for instant use? It's the laxative, you know, that both rids your body of waste and combats acidity. Why not get a bottle from your druggist at once and have it ready at all times in case of need? And when you remember the Hour of Smiles in Town Hall tonight, remember too, won't you, the two products of the Bristol-Myers Company that make these performances possible? They are Ipana toothpaste for the smile of beauty, Sal Hepatica for the smile of health. Ipana, Sal Hepatica. Now in just a few more seconds, we'll have the announcement of tonight's winners. And meanwhile, a little music, Peter. Because here's Fred with the final result.
Thank you. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the applause machine advises us that you have selected the Sickles Hayseeders, Betty Riley, and Paula Roberts. Now, I'm going to call out the names again, and as Tiny holds his lily-white hand over the head, or heads of these contestants, he's going to have an awful time getting his hand over the heads of the Sickles Hayseeders. I'll turn around and see how that looks when you do it. But as Tiny holds his hands over the heads of the various acts, your applause will decide the winners of first and second prizes. Are you ready, Tiny?
Ready, Fred.
First, the Sickle Hayseeders from Saugerties, who played Hand Me Down My Walking Cane. Next, Miss Paula Roberts, the last girl who sang Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. Third, Miss Betty Riley, the attractive young lady who sang I'll Always Be in Love with You.
You asked me what the machine said, Fred?
Yes, I asked you what the machine said, Tiny.
I'm just waiting for the
This is the machine age, and we must look out for the machine.
Well, okay, coming up over here now. Here they are, Fred.
Don't tell me that the
in
machine
the order name.
Slowed
yes,
down.
Sir.
Thank you. The first prize, $50, and a week's engagement at the Roxy Theater starting this coming Friday goes to Miss Paula Roberts, who sang Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. The second prize, $25 in cash, goes to the Sickles Hayseeders, the hillbilly band from Saugerties, New York. Congratulations to both of you, and to the others, many thanks for your excellent endeavors. And Tiny... 1 second. This is Fred Allen saying goodnight, ladies and gentlemen. And don't forget that next Wednesday night, the town hall doors will be opened wide for you one and all. You're invited to spend another hour with Portland, the mighty Allen R. Players, the Ipana Troubadours, the Town Hall Quartet, and another group of amateurs. Good night.
You and the Night and the Music is from Revenge of Music. Smoke Gets in Your Eyes from Roberta. This is the National Broadcasting Company.